Hi students, so in this class we are going to discuss another interesting topic, that is applications of second law of thermodynamics. Applications of second law of thermodynamics. This is unit 1, class 26. So in this class we are going to cover these topics. They are applications of second law of thermodynamics. Applications of second law of thermodynamics. So what are the applications of the second law of thermodynamics? Means in second law of thermodynamics we have two statements, Kelvin-Planck statement and Clausius statement. So according to Kelvin-Planck statement, we have a one example, that is heat engine. According to Clausius statement, we have a two examples, that one is refrigerator and second one is heat pump. So these are the applications of the second law of thermodynamics. Now let us see the applications of the second law of thermodynamics. So in second law of thermodynamics we have two important statements. They are Kelvin-Planck statement number 2, Clausius statement. So what is the Kelvin-Planck statement? What says Kelvin-Planck? What is the statement given by the Kelvin-Planck? Means already we have discussed in the previous class. Once again see. So it is impossible to construct an engine working in a cyclic process whose whole purpose is to convert heat energy into work. So this is the Kelvin-Planck statement. Example is heat engine. So finally, what does Kelvin-Planck statement give us? What does Kelvin-Planck statement give us? Means Kelvin-Planck statement for second law of thermodynamics gave us the understanding that no engine can give us 100% efficiency. 100% efficiency. So here we have a example for the Kelvin-Planck statement, that is heat engine. So what is heat engine? What is the heat engine? So what is heat engine? See here, this is a heat engine. How can we define heat engine? Means a device which transfers the energy from high temperature to low temperature. So here we have a high temperature, here we have a low temperature. A device which transfers the energy from high temperature to low temperature, high temperature to low temperature, and gives the work as a output, and gives the work as a output, is known as heat engine. Is known as heat engine. Examples, all automobile engines. See here we have a high temperature reservoir or high temperature source. Here we have a low temperature reservoir, that is sink. In between we have a heat engine. So high temperature reservoir supplies the heat to the heat engine. Okay, so by using this heat, that is QH heat, by using this heat, the heat engine will do some work. Heat engine will do some work, and remaining amount of heat will rejected to the low temperature reservoir. That is QL. Okay. So here, what is the work done by the heat engine? Means the difference of these two heats, we get the work done by the heat engine. That is QH minus QL. QH minus QL, where what is W, work done by the engine, and what is QH, heat transferred, and what is QL, heat transferred out, heat transferred into the heat engine, heat transferred from the heat engine. So that is QL in joules. Okay, so finally, how can we define heat engine? Means once again see, heat engine, it is a device which transfers the energy from high temperature to low temperature and gives the work as output, is known as heat engine. So example, all automobile engines. Next we will find the coefficient of performance of the heat engine or efficiency of the heat engine. See here, this is a high temperature reservoir, low temperature reservoir. So here the T1 is greater than T2, Okay, so work done by the heat engine, that is W. Heat supplied to the heat engine, that is Q1. Heat rejected by the heat engine, that is Q2. Okay, so Q1 is nothing but QH, Q2 is nothing but QL. So let us find the coefficient of performance of the heat engine or efficiency of the heat engine. Efficiency of the heat engine. So if you want to find the efficiency, we need to find the output and input. So what is the output here? What is output? Work done by the heat engine, that is the output. So output is equal to work done by the engine. So that is equal, W is equal to QH minus QL. So what is the input? See, here we have an input. QH is the input. From the higher temperature source, we are giving the heat input to the heat engine. That is a heat input. So input is nothing but what? Heat supplied to heat engine. That is QH. So finally, we have a output and input. By using these two, we can find the efficiency or coefficient of performance of the heat engine, or efficiency is equal to work output by input. Output by, if you want to find the efficiency, we have to know the output and input. Therefore, output by input, we get the efficiency or coefficient of performance of heat engine. So that is equal to W by work output is nothing but what? W is the output. W by input is the Q1. Okay. So therefore, W is equal to Q1 minus Q2 W by divided by Q1, or we can write it as 1 minus Q2 by Q1. So this is the coefficient of performance of the heat engine. Next, let us see the second statement, that is classes statement. Already we have studied the statement of the classes. What is the statement of the classes? Means without any external device, we cannot transfer the heat from low temperature to high temperature. We cannot transfer the heat from low temperature to high temperature without any external device. This is a statement of the classes. So example is refrigerator. Example is refrigerant. Finally, what does classes statement give us? Means classes statement for second law of thermodynamics gave us the concept of refrigeration of systems and heat pumps, since they were work on the given phenomena. They work on given phenomena. So here example is classes statement. Example is refrigerator and heat pump. Refrigerator and heat pump. So these two are the example for the classes statement. So what is refrigerator? What is a refrigerator? How can we define a refrigerator? Means, so the basic function of the refrigerator is to keep the body at low temperature. Basic function of the refrigerator is to keep the body at low temperature. So a device which cools and maintains the temperature of the body lower than its surrounding, that is known as refrigerator. That is known as refrigerator. Once again, listen. A device which cools and maintains the temperature of the body lower than its surrounding, that is known as refrigerator. Means if we compare the temperature inside the refrigerator and outside the refrigerator, so inside the temperature is inside the refrigerator temperature is lower than the surrounding, so that is called refrigerator. That is called refrigerator. Or we can devise in other ways, a device which is used to transfer the heat from low temperature to high temperature is called refrigerator. So it extract means, it means refrigerator extract the heat from cold body and deliver it to the atmosphere. So it means in this case work is done on the system. So here, so let us try to understand the refrigerator. So here we have a hot body and we have a cold body. In between we have a compressor. Okay, so this compressor will compress the heat from cold body to hot body. So it is taking the it is extracting the heat from the cold body, that is Q1, and supply it to the hot body, that is Q2. So if you want to transfer the heat from low temperature to high temperature, so we have to give the work input. So that is W by means of compressor. So that work is equal to difference of these two heats, that is Q2 minus Q1. I hope you understand. So next, where Q1 and Q2, what is the Q1 and Q2? So Q1 is nothing but quantity of heat supplied to the high temperature. Where Q2 is nothing but what? Quantity of heat removed from the low temperature region. So now let us find the coefficient of performance of refrigerator. So if you want to find the coefficient of performance of refrigerator, we need to find the output. So what is output here? Amount of heat taken from the cold body, that is Q2. And what is input? Work input, that is W is equal to Q2 minus Q1. Okay. So here we have the output and input. By using these two, we can find the efficiency or coefficient of performance of the refrigerator. So coefficient of performance of refrigerator is equal to, that is equal to efficiency, output by input. What is output? This one, Q2. Q2 is the output, and what is the input? Work input, W. So finally, Q1 minus Q2, or we can write it as T2 by T1 minus T2. This is the coefficient of performance of the refrigerator. Next, you can see the let us see the heat pump, last one, the last application of the second law of thermodynamics, that is heat pump. How can we define heat pump? A device which heats and maintains the temperature of the body higher than its surrounding, that is known as heat pump. Okay, so here we have a heat pump. This heat pump will receive the heat from the cold reservoir to, it supplies to hot reservoir. So let us find the coefficient of performance of the heat pump, or efficiency of the heat pump. So what is the output here? Amount of heat given to the room, that is QH. What is the input here? Work input. Work input, that is QH minus QL. Therefore, finally, what is the coefficient of performance or efficiency of the heat pump? That is equal to output by input. Therefore, coefficient of performance of the heat pump is equal to QH by W. QH by W. W is nothing but QH minus QC, or TH by TH minus TC. So this is the coefficient of performance of the heat engine. Once again, see the difference between a refrigerator and heat pump. Once again, all of you observe this one, you can get the idea of the heat pump and refrigerator, and difference between heat pump and refrigerator. Thank you so much.